Hello students, today we are going to study about chapter 2 of class 8 science. The chapter name is Microorganisms, Friend and Foe. How these microorganisms are helpful to us and what are the disadvantages of these microorganisms. So let's start with the chapter. You have seen several kind of plants and animals. However, there are other living organisms around us which we normally cannot see. These are called microorganisms or microbes. For example, you might have observed that during the rainy season, moist bread gets spoiled and its surface gets covered with grayish white patches. Observe these patches through a magnifying glass. You will see tiny black rounded structure. Do you know what these structure are and where do these come from? So for that, let's try one activity, microorganisms. For that, one activity is given to you. Collect some moist soil from the field in a beaker and add water to it. After the soil particles have settled down, observe a drop of water from the beaker under the microscope. What do you see? So you will see the microorganisms in the slide. Therefore, its conclusion of the activity is that the microorganisms live in soil. Whenever you found this moist bread gets spoiled and some patches on it, it's a microorganism or kind of fungi. Another activity was also given to you. Take a few drops of water from a pond and spread on the glass slide and observe through a microscope. So, in the pond water, there is also many different microbes are present in that water and these occur in the pond water as well. Do you find tiny organisms moving around? If you conduct this activity, you will find that some microorganisms are there which are moving around. So, these observations show that water and soil are full of tiny organisms or microorganisms. Though not all of them fall into the category of microbes, these microorganisms or microbes are small in size. They cannot be seen with the unaided or bare eyes. Some of these, such as fungus that grows on bread, can be seen with a magnifying glass. But others cannot be seen without the help of a microscope. This is why these are called microorganisms or microbes. Now, microorganisms are classified into four major groups. And these groups are bacteria, fungi, protozoa, and some algae. Some of these common microorganisms are shown in the next figure or next picture we will see. Viruses are also microscopic, but are different from the microorganisms. They, however, reproduce only inside the cell of the host organism, which may be a bacterium, plant or animal. Some of these viruses are also shown to you on the next page. Common ailments like cold, influenza or flu and most coughs are caused by these viruses. These diseases are caused by the viruses, as now the corona is also a disease which is spread by the virus. Serious diseases like polio and chickenpox are also caused by viruses. The diseases like dysentery and malaria are caused by protozoa or protozoans, whereas typhoid and tuberculosis are bacterial diseases. This is caused by the bacteria. In dysentery, you will feel the symptoms of diarrhea. This is a kind of disease which is caused by the protozoa. You have learned about some of these microorganisms in class 6 and 7. So now let me see the different bacteria and other types of microorganisms. So here in the figure, the bacteria are shown to you, different type of bacteria. Here algae is shown to you. In this, Chlamydomonas and Spirogyra, two different types of algae, is shown to you. Then after here, Protozoa is also shown to you, that is amoeba and paramecium. These are the example of this kind of microorganism. Next, here the types of different types of fungi is shown to you, that is bread mold, penicillium and aspergillus. These are the different types of fungi. Now let me see the different type of viruses. So these are shown to you, two different types of viruses. So now, have you ever thought that where do microorganisms live? So microorganism, this may be single cell like bacteria, some algae and protozoa, or multicellular such as many algae and fungi. They live in all types of environment ranging from ice cold climate to hot spring and desert to marshland. Marshland, that means a marsh is a type of wetland, an area of land where water covers ground for long period of time. This may be, they are also found inside the body of animals including humans. And some microorganisms grow on the other organisms while others exist freely. So these are the places where these microorganisms live. Now, microorganisms and us. So microorganisms play an important role in our lives. Some of them are beneficial in many ways, whereas some others are harmful and cause disease. Let us study about them in the detail, that how these are helpful or beneficial to us. So first is friendly microorganisms. So microorganisms are used for various purposes. They are used in the preparation of curd, butter and as well as in cake. And microorganisms have been used for the production of alcohol since ages. Since long time, it is used to make the alcohol also. They are also used in cleaning up of the environment. For example, the organic waste, that is vegetable peels, remains of animals and feces, etc., are broken down into harmless and usable substance by the bacteria or by these microorganisms. Recall that bacteria are also used in the preparation of medicines. In agriculture, they are used to increase soil fertility by fixing nitrogen. So its first use is given to you, making of curd and bread. You have learned in class 7 that milk is turned into curd by bacteria. So pahali now wonder this, that I saw that my mother added a little curd to warm milk to set curd for the next day. I wonder why. So now let me see why her mother is adding curd into the warm milk. So curd contains several microorganisms of this bacterium. Lactobacillus promotes the formation of curd. It multiplies in milk and converts it into curd. Bacteria are also involved in the making of cheese, pickles and many other food items. An important ingredient of rava or suji, you can say, rava idli or bhature, is curd. Can you guess why? Because they help to ferment the fermentation of the food. Bacteria and yeast are also helpful for the fermentation of rice idlis and dosa batters. So now we will see how this curd form from the milk. So when milk is heated to a temperature of 30 to 40 degrees centigrade and a small amount of old curd is added to it, the lactobacillus in that curd sample gets activated and multiplies this, convert the lactose into lactic acid, which imparts the sour taste to curd. And this is how the curd is prepared. So these bacteria or microorganisms are helpful to make curd or bread or the fermented food. One activity is given to you. Take a half kg of flour, atta or maida, and add some sugar and mix with warm water. Now add a small amount of yeast powder and knead to make a soft dough. What do you observe after 2 hours? Did you find the dough rising? So first, here in the picture, the maida with the yeast powder is shown to you, and after 2 hours, what will you observe? That is, raised maida is shown to you. After 2 hours, you will find that dough of maida rises and becomes soft or fluffy, or growth of yeast occurred in the dough of maida. So yeast reproduces rapidly and produces carbon dioxide during the respiration. The bubbles of the gas fill the dough and increases its volume. As we can see, its volume is almost the double of earlier. This is the basis of the use of yeast in baking industry for making breads, pastries and cakes. So now next we will see the another use of this microorganism. It is commercial use of microorganisms. So microorganisms are produced for a large scale production of alcohol, wine and acetic acid, that is vinegar. Yeast is used for commercial production of alcohol and wine. For this purpose, yeast is grown on natural sugars present in the grains like barley, wheat, rice, crushed fruit juices, etc. One activity is given here. Take a 500 ml beaker filled up to 3/4 with water. Now dissolve 2 to 3 teaspoons of sugar in it and half of spoon of yeast powder to the sugar solution. Keep it covered in a warm place for 4 to 5 hours. Now smell this solution. Can you get a smell? So here the observation is given to you. The smell, this is the smell of alcohol, as sugar has been converted into the alcohol by yeast, and this process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is known as the fermentation. And this was invented or discovered by Louis Pasteur in 1857. So Louis Pasteur discovered fermentation in 1857. The next use is medicinal use of microorganism. So whenever you fall ill, the doctor may give you some antibiotic tablets, capsules or injections such as of penicillin. The source of these medicines is microorganisms, and these medicines kill or stop the growth of the disease causing microorganisms, and such type of medicines are called antibiotics. These days, a number of antibiotics are being produced from these bacteria and fungi. Like here, the examples is given to you: streptomycin, tetracycline and erythromycin are some of the example commonly used antibiotics which are made from fungi and bacteria. Here in 1929, Alexander Fleming was working on a culture of disease causing bacteria. Suddenly he found the spores of a little green mold in one of his culture plates. He observed that the presence of mold prevented the growth of bacteria. In fact, it also killed many of these bacteria. From this, the mold penicillin was prepared. So we had seen some commonly used antibiotics which is made from fungi and bacteria. These antibiotics are manufactured by growing specific microorganisms and used to cure a variety of disease. Antibiotics are even mixed with the feed of livestock or cattle stock and poultry to check microbial infections in animals. They are also used to control many plant diseases. Now it is important to remember that antibiotics should be taken only on the advice of a qualified doctor. Also, you must complete the course of prescribed by the doctor. If you take antibiotics when not needed or in wrong doses, it may make the drug less effective when you might need it in future. So also antibiotics taken unnecessarily may kill the beneficial bacteria in the body. And antibiotics, however, are not effective against cold and flu, as these are caused by the virus. So you have to take these antibiotics only on the advice of the qualified doctor. So here the another next use is given to you, that is to make the vaccine. So have you ever wondered that why are children or infants given vaccination? So when a disease carrying microbes enter our body, the body produces antibodies to fight the invader. The body also remembers how to fight the microbes if it enters again. If dead air or weakened microbes are introduced into a healthy body, the body fights and kills the invading or coming bacteria by producing suitable antibodies. The antibodies remain in the body and we are protected from the disease-causing microbes for lifetime. And this is how vaccine works. Several diseases including cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox, hepatitis can be prevented by the vaccination. So here one fact is given to you that Edward Jenner discovered the vaccine for smallpox in 1798. In your childhood, you must have been given injections to protect yourself against several diseases. Can you prepare a list of these diseases? And you can also take help of the parents. You might get vaccination for the disease like diphtheria, chickenpox, mumps, whooping cough, measles, rubella, hepatitis A, etc. You can make your own list. It is essential to protect all children against this disease. Necessary vaccines are available in the nearby hospitals. You might have seen the advertisement on TV and newspapers regarding protection of children against polio under the Pulse Plus Polio program. The polio drops given to the children are actually a vaccine. The worldwide campaign against smallpox has finally led to its eradication from most part of the world. These days, vaccines are made on the large scale from microorganisms to protect humans and other animals from several diseases. So this is the one use of microorganisms. It is used to make the vaccine. The next use is increasing soil fertility. So some bacteria, which is given on the next page, are able to fix nitrogen from the atmosphere to enrich this soil with the nitrogen and increase its fertility. And these microbes are commonly called biological nitrogen fixer. So let me see some of these microorganisms. So the nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria is shown to you, that is blue-green algae. This fixes the atmospheric nitrogen into the soil. So here next one, another use or advantage of this microorganism is given to you, that is cleaning the environment. So Bujaho and Pehli had observed the school gardener making manure. Along with the friend, they collected waste of plants, vegetables and fruits from the nearby houses and gardens. They put them in a pit meant for waste disposal. After some time, it decomposed and got converted to manure. Bujaho and Pehli wanted to know how this had happened. So for that, one activity is given here. Take two pots and fill each pot half with soil. Now mark them A and B. Put plant waste in pot A and things like polythene bags, empty glass bottles and broken plastic toys in pot B. Put the pots aside Observe them after 3 to 4 weeks. So what will you observe? The plant waste in a pot A has been decomposed, but not any change is seen in pot B. And the plant waste has been converted into manure by the action of microbes. We had earlier seen the activity that using this type of manure, plant can grow easily and the growth of the plant is higher as compared to the other plants. So do you find any difference in the contents of the two pots? If so, what is the difference that we had discussed already? So you will find that plant waste in pot A has been decomposed. How did this happen? The plant waste has been converted into manure by the action of microbes. The nutrients released in the process can be used by the plants again. Did you notice that in pot B, the polythene bags, empty glasses, bottles and broken toy parts did not undergo any such change? The microbes could not act on them and convert them into manure. So they are as it is as before 3 to 4 weeks. You often see large amount of dead organic matter in the form of decaying plants or sometimes dead animals on the ground. You find that they disappear after some time. This is because the microorganisms decompose the dead organic waste of plants and animals, converting them into simple substance. And these substances are again used by other plants and animals. Thus, microorganisms can be used to degrade the harmful and smelly substance and thereby cleaning up the environment. This is how these microorganisms clean the environment. So till now, what we had seen in this chapter, that certain organisms which are too small to be seen with naked or bare eyes are called microorganisms. The microorganisms are classified into 4 major groups, that is bacteria, fungi, algae and protozoa. Viruses are also microorganisms, but they differ from the other microbes. Viruses are obligatory intracellular parasites. That means they are depending on the other animals or plants or bacteria. Virus is a connecting link between non-living and living. Microorganisms are unicellular. Example of that is bacteria, yeast, protozoa, chlamydomonas, etc. Or multicellular, example of that is pyrogyra and penicillium. Microorganisms can live alone or may live in colonies. Some are free living and others are intraparasites. That means they are depending on the others. Microorganisms can survive under all types of environment, ranging from ice cold climate to hot spring and deserts to marshlands. Some microorganisms are beneficial to us. They are used in the preparation of curd, bread, cake, alcohol, medicines, wine, vinegar, etc. And they decompose organic waste and convert it into harmless and usable substance. Rhizobium bacteria and blue-green algae are commonly called biological nitrogen fixers. They are fixing the atmospheric nitrogen into the soil. Then we had seen fermentation. That is the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol and anaerobically is called fermentation. Then we had seen antibiotics. So chemical substances produced by some microbes can kill or stop the growth of the disease causing microorganisms are called antibiotics. The example of antibiotics is penicillin, then streptomycin, tetracycline, etc. Then we had seen antibodies. Our body produces specific substance against disease causing microbes entering in our body are called antibodies. And we had seen what discoveries made by some of the scientists in microbiology. So Louis Pasteur discovered fermentation by yeast and pasteurization of milk. Then we had seen Alexander Fleming discovered penicillin antibiotic. And Dr. Edward Jenner discovered vaccine for smallpox. So now in the next video, we will see the harmful microorganisms. What are the disadvantages of these microorganisms and disease causing microorganisms in the human? Thank you.